try the C program to sort a list of n elements using bubble sort. Okay, so this is the technique here. Now we are familiar again with these variables. Okay, A stands for the array. We have the variable n for the asking the user how many elements he wants to enter. The variable I and j will be used in the loop for iteration. Two for loops we will use, and one variable temp. So can you tell me why we have used the variable temp? Save the temporary variable, because we are going to make use of the same code that you had in C program for swapping of two numbers. Fine. Coming to the next lines of code here, we are familiar with this. We accept the elements and store it in the array. Now the main logic will start from here. Fine. Let's start now. We'll simultaneously go with the tracing. Okay, I will open the Excel sheet. So have a look here. The variables are taken. First variable I. Let us, we need not show this n. You people remember this. So I less than n. Accordingly with this, I less than, this has to be n. Minus 1, j is equal to 0. The moment we come to this, we will not increment, no? We are going to go to the inside loop. So j is equal to 0, j less than n minus I minus 1, that is there. Then after this becomes true, we are going to go for the if condition. So the if condition is given here, the swap. After this condition becomes true, we will swap. And then the two incrementing variables. Fine. Let us now start. Initially, the value of I starts with 0. Have a look at the different elements that I have. Are they in sorted order? Alright. They are mixed, they are jumbled. So I becomes 0. Let us check for is 0. Less than n, value of n is 6, 6 minus 1, 5. So is 0 less than 5? Next thing, after we have come here, we need to go for j. J becomes equal to 0. What is the next condition? J less than n. So it should be what? 0 less than 6. Minus 0, 6 minus 0 is 6, minus 1, 5. Calculate once again and tell me, is it correct? 0 less than 5. So the condition is true. So if this condition is true here, we go in the j's for loop. Okay. If A of J is greater than A of J plus 1, A of J is greater than A of J plus 1. Let me write here. Then A of 0, A of 0 had the element 10. A of J plus 1. A of 0 plus 1 is what? 1. A of 1 is holding which element? 14. So is 10 less than 40? False. Sorry. The condition is true. So we are not going to... Sorry. is greater than 40, so the condition becomes false. So do we need to swap now? No, they will retain their same position. So this next is going to be skipped. What is going to be the next statement? J will be incremented. The value of J becomes 1. Next, which statement shall we execute? J has become 1. We are still in the J loop. We are not in the outside. We are in the inside loop. So J has become 1 means we will come here. J has become 1. So we will continue with the inner loop itself. You remember when we were swapping, I made use of the term pass. Right? So see, this is the first pass. First pass refers to your outer loop when I becomes equal to 0. So when we are in the 0th iteration, we are carrying out our J loop. How many times? You observe now. Okay? So now J has become 1. 1 should be less than 5, which is again true. Now compare the elements. The value of J is 1. Okay? So we are here. We are comparing 40 and 30. We are comparing these two. We need not swap because 10 is at the right place. Next, we need to compare 40 and 30. So, between 40 and 30, do we need to swap? Yes. Let's go back here. So, let me first write here, comparing 40, is it greater than 30? It is true. So, we shall swap. I will write the swap trials here. Okay. So, I will write 30, 40. And also what I will do is, we tried to swap it in this iteration. So let me paste it here. What is the element here? 10. So we have swapped 40 and 30. Right? Now, after this, we will increment J. So J is going to be 2. This. So we are still in the inner loop of the bigger, the I's loop, the inside loop is J. So we are still in the J's loop. So let's again start with when J is 2. So you compare again, is 2 less than 5? Yes. Compare the element, next two elements. We need to compare these two, 40 and 22. So let us write 40. 22. Do we need to swap? Yes. So again we shall have 22 and 40. So 22 will come here and 40 is going to be here. Is the swapping correct? Okay. Next we will increment J. Check for the condition, is 3 less than 5. Now compare the third index A of J with the fourth index. See, do not refer to the previous. Okay. After swapping, the updated array I have written here for that purpose. So we need to refer this. So check 40 and 50. They are correct. We need not swap them. Let us write here. Let us write the comparison 40. Greater than 50, which is false. So we will not swap, we will only increment. Is it correct? Yes. Next, 4 is done. Let's go back to the program. Check the condition here now. Remember this. J has become 4. I'll write here 4. 4 less than 5 still holds true. Compare the 4th and the 5th element. 4th and the 5th. We need to swap because A of J, that is A of 4, which is 50, is greater than A of J plus 1. J plus 1 is 5, which is 16. So we are comparing 50 is greater than 16, which is true, and we will swap it. 16, 50. Let me write here again the updated value. So we are swapping which one? 16. And 50. Okay. Now, let us increment the value of j. Let us come back to the loop. Check for the condition is 5. Less than 5? False. Okay. Now, if you observe this here, just observe here, when I was 0, how many times did the j loop run? 5 times, correct? The value of n is 6. So j loop ran for n minus I minus 1 times. But now you observe the array. With our first pass or our first iteration of I, has the largest element gone to the correct place? Correct? 50 was the largest. It has gone to its correct place, that is at the last. Fine. Now let's continue. Now have a look here again. This particular thing has become false. We need to increment I. Okay, we incremented j. J became 5. So 5 is not less than 5. So what will happen? We will not go inside this for loop. The for loop contains these swapping conditions. So we are not going to go inside. We will come out of this loop, and at the out of the loop we have to increment. You are understanding the flow? So we will increment I now. The value of I now becomes 1. Again, check if 1 is less than n minus 1. The value of n is 6. 6 minus 1, 5. So where should we start again? J loop. We have again once again come here. Again j becomes equal to 0. Okay. So again here 0. Check for the condition again 0 less than j. Less than, what is the value of j? 0 less than 6 minus 1 minus 1. So this time the loop is only going to run for 1 less than the previous. With each pass, that is what we observed. No? The moment this CR of your class came here, that is Prajwal, the tallest or the largest element, we were not moving him. We were only continuing the swapping with those remaining elements. The swapping only happened there. So one element is less, so only the swapping is happening there up to n minus 1. So 0 is less than 4. Next, let us compare now. So where A, we have to compare A of J greater than A of J plus 1. Value of J is 0 at the 0th index. So you compare 10 and 30. So is 10 greater than 30? False. So if it is false, we need not swap. We will only increment the value of J and make it 1. Let's start again and check if 1 is less than n minus I minus 1, which is true. So you compare now the first element and the second. The value of j is 1. A of 1 is 30. A of j plus 1, which is 1 plus 1, which is 2, which is 22. So is 30 greater than 22? Yes. So what we need to do? Swap there. Places. So let us write here. J. Check for again is 2 less than 4. Compare the second element with the third element. Is 30 greater than 40? False. need not swap. Implement. Check for 3 less than 4, which is true. Check for A of j greater than j plus 1. This time it is true. So we have 40 greater than 16. We need to again swap. So let me write again the updated values here. Which two elements did we swap? 40 and 16. Increment the value of j, which is 4. Now check for the fourth iteration of j, 4 less than 4, which is false. So now again observe here. This was your second pass. This is called as the second pass. In the second pass, at the end, is the second largest element at its correct place? Is 40 at the correct place? Yes. Now we are left only with sorting of these four elements. The largest, the second largest element are at correct positions. Let's continue again. Now you tell me, since here 4 has become less than 4, which is false. Again, I am repeating, we shall not go inside the for loop. We shall come here, increment the variable I. So the variable I now becomes 2. Okay, let's check again. Is 2 less than 5? The j value again will start from 0. So you tell now, 0 less than what? 3. N, 6 minus I, the value of I is 2. 6 minus 2, 4 minus 1, which is 3. So this is true. Next, compare again. 10 and 22, they are at the correct places. So no need to swap. So let me just write it here. 10 greater than 22, which is false. No swapping, increment the j operator. So what is the value of j? 1. Check for 1 less than 3. Compare the first element with the second. 22 greater than 30. False. Will increment j. Now, 2 less than 3, compare the second element with the third. Have a look at the index if you want. Compare the second element with the third. We are doing correct. So, 30 greater than 16, which is true. Now, this time we have to swap it. So, we will say 16 and 30 here. Let us write the updated array values. Now, last, we implement this. So, you know here, for the when j becomes 3, we have 3 less than 3, which is false. So, observe for the second third pass. 30, the third largest element in our array, is at the correct place. And the last three elements are sorted. We are only left with these three. Let's continue with this. What is going to be the value of I now? Check for 3 less than 5, which is true. J, 0. J starts from 0 again. So, 0 less than, which is true. Let's compare A of 0 with A of 1. 10 and 22, which is false. No swapping. Increment. Make the value of J as 1. Check for 1 less than 2. Check for the first element and the second element. We need to swap? Yes. So 22 is greater than 16. So we need to swap, put 16 at the correct place. So let us write the updated array. Now you can tell me when j becomes, is the condition still true? So 2 is not less than 2, which is false. And now if you observe here, these are sorted. And even if you observe here, all the entire array is sorted, correct? But will the loop still run? Yes, the loop has to run. So this has become false. What will be the next increment? I. The value of I becomes 4. Check for 4 less than 5, which is true. Start with j equal to 0. Check for what? 0 less than 1, which is true. So this is going to be executed only one time now. So check for these two. No need to swap. We are going to increment the value of j. So this time when j becomes 1, this condition is false. So this particular loop is going to stop there. The last time the value I increments, and here we check for the condition, which is false. So now with each pass, what is happening is the largest element is moving to its correct position. Right? So we were trying to sort here in which, ascending or descending? Ascending, smallest to largest. You can also sort it in the reverse order, descending to ascending. Even that is possible. Students who are online, do you have any doubts? Attention on the screen. You tell me now how many elements we can change the output, because we have already traced for that program. Tell me the elements. 10, 18, 22,
27,
29, 40, 31. 15 minus 10. Check how many elements are over. 10 elements are done. We have 8 elements, no, not 10. So check if it is in sorted order. Minus 10, 10, 18, 22, 29, 30, 31, and 50. Fine. Right?